Hello, I'm Trevor Young, Dean of the Faculty of Medicine at University of Toronto. I'm joined today by Dr. Marcus Law, Director of Preclerkship Renewal. So how does the new curriculum benefit our medical students, and how does it enhance quality of teaching?
The foundations curriculum builds on our strengths and provides students with a highly integrated and active learning experience. So some of the changes are early exposure to clinical content to promote learning in context, and their intelligent and innovative use of e-learning materials, competency-based assessment program that drives learning, and also a modern case-based learning experience where students actually learn how to interact with the virtual patients that mimic authentic learning experience as well.
So is there less emphasis on, for instance, traditional classroom learning and lectures? Is that what our students have to look forward to?
So students will have more face time with an active learning experience with the faculty. We are going to use more flipped classroom style, which means the students will do a lot more pre-readings or interact with a virtual patient or e-learning module before they come to class, before they come to lectures. So the lecture time will be more valuable time interacting with the materials and actually allow the students to ask questions to the content experts in the classroom.
Why now? Why is this the time to do this?
As the healthcare environment change and expectations of Canadians change, and also new healthcare priorities emerge, it's our responsibility to prepare our students to provide excellent healthcare today and also in the future. So we are revitalizing the preclerkship curriculum to ensure the program, first, is forefront of medical education, and also second, to keep pace with emerging healthcare priorities. The approach is supported by recent medical education literature, and in fact, many medical schools in Canada and around the world have pursued or are pursuing substantial changes. We also excited the process will generate lots of knowledge so that we can give back to the medical education community with the help of Wilson Center.
So Marcus, how do you think this curriculum compares to your own experience in medical school? Is this something you think would have helped you get to where you are today, or learn better or faster?
Being a graduate of U of T Medical School, I remember how learning in medicine is like here many years ago. But definitely it's a modernized curriculum with, for example, the use of e-learning, the use of virtual patients, the use of case-based learning.
So I know we're gradually introducing this curriculum. Some students have started and will have a full implementation in 2016-2017. So what's the feedback from our students so far?
So we received very positive feedback from students. For example, many students remarked on how learning in context promotes retention. They also appreciate having the input in shaping the new curriculum as well. One student even told us that active and authentic learning experience in the new curriculum reminds them of why they chose medicine in the first place.
What can you tell other alumni about opportunities for them in supporting or getting involved with this new curriculum?
For example, there will be more opportunities for them to provide shadowing or observership experiences in their practice. And also alumni can also become teachers in our program. And we'll love to hear from anyone interested in getting involved in the process.
Well, thank you, Marcus, for taking the time to tell us about the new curriculum and all the exciting changes ahead for our MD students.